Hey, everyone. Blockchain Bernie here. This episode is about crypto scams, and especially on the Solana blockchain, we have some reports out there of wallet drainers, and believe it or not, even some of our team members have been fallen victim to that. So, you know, we need to figure out what does that mean for the state of crypto? What does it mean for Solana? 2024 is supposed to be a great year for crypto in general and for Solana, but will these scams and these wallet drainers, will they really, you know, make it not a good year? So let's dive right into it. So I've prepared some things for you here. And the most important thing is you need to protect yourself from all of these scams, right? And if you're on our Discord, right, it's about Xandeum.com, and you can join our Discord there. We have about 1,500 members right now, and there is scam lookouts there all the time, right? So if there's anything related to Xandeum and we're building a scalable storage layer for the Solana chain, we will be alerting you on our Discord, on the scam lookout channel, right? So, but hey, what does it all mean here? So let's have a look at this article here, right? And let's start with this one. Wallet drainers plague Solana to siphon over $4 million in 30 days, right? So that's an article here on dailycoin.com, and they're citing a sniffer here that has found out that, you know, there are wallet drainers, 4 million in the last 30 days. So what does $4 million actually mean, right? It sounds like a lot of money, but let's compare it with the fraud rates that we see elsewhere on other chains, and also on, you know, classic payment methods like credit cards and stuff like that. So let's dive into it. What we see here is DeFi Llama. So we see what has been going on here in the last 30 days with the Solana chain. The blue thing in the top is the TVL, the total value locked. So we're at about, you know, between $2 and $2.5 billion right now with the total value locked in the Solana chain. And then with the volume, you see on average the past 30 days, it was always like almost like $1 billion, let's say $700 million times 30, right? So that's about what's going on here in volume, right? So 700 million times 30, right? In the last 30 days, that'd be $21 billion, right? That was the trading volume, and now 4 million out of that has been fraud, right? So that's a small percentage, right? So if we say 4 million divided by 21 billion, so that's just yeah, 0.19%, right? So 0.19%, is that true? It says 1.9 e-4, right? So that would be, yeah, I think it's 0.19%. And if you look at the Visa network here, right? The card not present balancing act, right? So we cannot compare crypto fraud rates with credit card fraud rates in general, because 80% of the credit card fraud, 70 to 80% of the fraud happens in what's called CNP transactions. That's card not present transactions. So that's basically e-commerce where people just type in their credit card details over the internet, right? So like POS, like you're in a store presenting your card, or you have a contractor coming to your home and they have their card reader, you present your card, that would be the card is present, right? But the CNP, that's the card not present, that's where all the fraud is happening, right? And that fraud, overall credit card fraud is 0.035%, but most of it is happening for CNP transactions, right? So for CNP transactions, we're at almost 1% fraud rate, right? So that is really a lot. And if we compare that to the 4 million, you know, out of 21 billion on the Solana chain, that is, you know, way less than with credit card fraud, card not present credit card fraud. And why am I saying all this, right? I hate people that always bring the negative stuff in the press. And I personally know a few people in my network, in my personal network, say like, oh, crypto and Bitcoin, and it's only going to be used by the gangsters and the fraudsters and all that kind of stuff, right? And I mean, it happens with so many people, intelligent people, stuff like that, right? Please think about, this is only the stuff that you read in the news, right? The news don't write you, oh, 100 million transactions have been processed on this and that blockchain without any issues and without any fraud. Nobody will click that, right? So what they do is they only write about, you know, what's happening with fraud and all that kind of stuff, but it's happening everywhere, right? And then is that argument like, oh, it's anonymous on the blockchain? First of all, it's not really anonymous, right? It's actually public. Those are all public blockchains. Each and every transaction is visible there. And with all the KYC requirements, with all the banks that and the crypto exchanges that do the on-ramp and off-ramp, it is actually not anonymous at all. And you know what is totally anonymous is cash, right? So these people that argue like, hey, crypto is only going to be used by the criminals and stuff like that. I mean, cash has been used by criminals all over the place, and it's still legal, and nobody's saying like, hey, let's abolish cash because it's only used by the criminals, right? So those are all those things, but it just means, you know, be careful. Just the same thing as with credit card fraud, with bank account fraud. And I had one employee a few years back, someone really hacked into his laptop and got access to his checking account, right? And drained his checking account, right? So these things happen everywhere. It is not crypto specific, but also with crypto, be careful, right? So we have that scam lookout channel on our Discord. Watch out there all the time. And then if there's links in NFTs, so many people send you NFTs, unsolicited NFTs, and then they, you know, they try to entice you to click on the links that are in those NFTs. Don't click these links, right? And just before you know, if you have been sent something unsolicited, always be suspicious. And then there are so many emails or websites about airdrops, right? And people Google for airdrops. They want to find out, hey, what's going on with this and that airdrop? And then they find some page on Google, and then they click on that link, connect their wallet, and boom, right? So you have to do a little bit of research before you click on links that you just found on Google, or that just come unsolicited with an NFT or even tokens that come into your wallet in an unsolicited way. And always check on these projects, do some double checks, go back to people that you know and ask them, hey, is this legit or not? You know, the same rules, whether it's, you know, for your bank account or for credit cards or for crypto. This is not a crypto specific thing, but it's happening also in crypto, right? So you need to be careful, but you also need to understand that this is not a crypto-specific problem. All right, so this was my latest episode. I hope you like content like this. If you do, please, please destroy that like button for me, because that like button is so important for the YouTube algorithm. And I thank you in advance to do that. Also, subscribe to my channel. Lots of crypto educational stuff, commentary on news that's going on. And most importantly, it's a progress log here on my YouTube channel about the Xandeum chain. So whatever we're developing here on Xandeum, you know, I'm just keeping you up to date there. And again, we have 1500 guys on our Discord. Go to xandeum.com in the top right corner. You can join our Discord. Please also follow us on Twitter. And you can do that through the website also, xandeum.com. Also, we have one of the highest performing Solana validators out there. It's called the Xandeum Validator. It has a very high APY, average percentage yield. If you have any Sol and you're not staking it, you're leaving money on the table. You are not risking your capital. You are not risking your Sol. We cannot access it when you stake it with us. It's all the staking works through the Solana blockchain. And yeah, we are one of the highest performing there, have been like that for months and months. And, you know, you get the highest returns when you stake directly to a validator that you trust. And go to xandeum.com and you find that stake sol there also. It's stake-sol.xandeum.com. But you can just go to xandeum.com and you find that button there to stake your sol. All right. So for now, thanks again for watching. Catch you guys later. Bye for now.